In the past, powerhouses used to be more than just utilitarian structures. At the dawn of the electrical age, those buildings were soaring temples, which should change the world forever. While functionality is more important than design in modern power stations, it seems like architecture had a special meaning back then. But more and more of those historical sites disappear. As fans of the aesthetics of industrialism, we simply had to explore two plants on our Hungary adventure, which seemed to be the last of their kind. The first place is a time capsule that already existed like that 100 years ago. The second one impresses thanks to its sheer size and the post-apocalyptic look. Join us on two exciting infiltrations of some of the most powerful witnesses of the past you can imagine. If you enjoy our videos, make sure to hit the subscribe button and click the bell to get notified when we upload new content. Bygone splendor and pomp were the topics of our recent two episodes. As a prelude to our new road trip series, we devoted ourselves to a neglected but grand architecture. For that, next to a historical cinema, we were also exploring abandoned stately buildings in and around Hungary. It was an immersive travel back to the past. Next to the beauty of decay, we were also searching for the reasons why those places could have been buried in oblivion in the first place. But on our five-day adventure, we also wanted to awake other old ruins from their deep slumber. We have started with the easy ones as a warm-up. In this episode, however, we focus on two tough nuts. The night before, we checked in at an odd Airbnb. Usually we sleep outdoors during our journeys. But the next location was in the middle of a metropolitan area. Instead of pitching our tent in some park or under a bridge again, we were looking for the cheapest shelter we could find. So actually we should have expected to end up in some sketchy dump. It was covered in more kitsch than most of the abandoned hoarder homes we've explored before.
Is it morning or evening? That's what I'm asking at the bibliothek.
Jetzt kommen wir direkt zur nächsten Fragestellung.
Ist es morgens oder abends?
Die Uhr geht nicht. Es geht jetzt los.
After only a few hours of sleep, we were already starting the day.
Tetris.
We have heard of tough security at the first power station we wanted to infiltrate that day. To increase our mission's chance of success, we wanted to be on site as early as possible. Our friend and guide Toby was telling us the exact plan one more time.
Also zeig mal hier, wo die Leiter ist. Und hier wird es
sein. Toby managed to get inside the plant only a short time ago. So he knew all the weak spots of the premises. But due to the high risk, he didn't want to join us today. So we were on our own and absorbed every single detail Toby shared with us.
Ja. Und dann einfach rauf die 5 Meter oder was die ist. Und durch die Zwischendecke durch. Einfach immer geradeaus, auf den Quergang überqueren, dann kommt sie zum Kontrollraum. Ja.
Klingt doch machbar. Mhm.
Half an hour later. At this time we had overcome the first obstacles. No, it wasn't even trespassing. Already earlier there were some other problems. Please understand that we can't show you the entrance in detail. We reserve to change the chronology of our exploration to make it harder for imitators. The only purpose of that is to protect the location. Yeah, we have discussed the plan like 100 times. But in the heat of the moment, with all the excitement, it's hard to keep a cool head. But actually, this was mandatory for a success of the mission. We think that we were lucky with the weather. Because of the rain, there were only a few pedestrians who could have spotted us. And we just hope that security didn't feel like patrolling. In order to stay away from CCTV, we had to move fast and look for cover in the overgrown parts of the site. After a couple of minutes, we reached the building with the access point. An open window served as an entrance. In complete darkness, we now started searching for the ladder Toby mentioned earlier. We were far behind schedule, but this is it. Right above our heads is the reason why we were willing to take the great risk. Believe us when we say it was totally worth it. Did you ever see something as crazy as this? This control room in Art Deco style is a real monument to industrial art. The oval decorative glass ceiling with the endless displays, switches and buttons right beneath it are showing the duality between the ornate style of the turn of the century and functional, mechanical modernity. To us, this room had the strange sci-fi movie-like atmosphere of an alien spaceship command center. The control room is just a small part of this defunct and retired powerhouse. But it is for sure the most impressive one. After a construction period of 2 years, it started to produce electricity here in 1940. Back then, this used to be the very first boiler house and power supply of the city. The building was even that modern that it was Europe's first electricity exchange. The control room, as it outlasted till today, wasn't constructed before 1927. After World War II, the power plant was converted to produce district heating. The massive building complex was extended and modernized several times to meet the growing requirements of power generation. In the course of the years, it became the biggest power station of the country and the most modern one in all of Central Europe. As recently as in 2005, large parts of the facility were deactivated and stripped down. The control room, however, remained as it always used to be. All the control panels rest untouched and are theoretically still operational. Maybe you're wondering what this oddly placed bunker here is all about. Well, it's said that the control room was an easy target for bombings in World War II because of the noticeable glass ceilings. The small shelter should protect the personnel in case of air raids. But luckily, the power station came through the war unscathed. After losing track of time completely in this impressive control room, we eventually moved on. Some other parts of the power station should still be accessible. We have found the turbine hall. Although you can see the partial demolition quite well here, we didn't dare to go inside. As you might notice, this area is still active to this day. At the moment, the powerhouse is in private hands and still produces energy. It's responsible for about 4% of Hungary's electricity supply. Nowadays, however, most of the country's energy comes from facilities in Russia and Ukraine. This place couldn't compete and needed to shut down as a consequence. While some parts of the power station fell victim to vandalism at some point in the past, strangely enough, there are other parts which seem to be totally untouched. The partial demolition of the plant was terminated one day. Since the powerhouse is already over 100 years old, it counts as industrial heritage site and is under special protection. It's not allowed to tear it down, but due to strict and binding requirements, the building complex can't be restored as well. Even basic maintenance can't be conducted, and so the condition of the historical place gets worse every day. However, the motion picture industry is benefiting from that. In the past, the power plant was a set for different kinds of films again and again. Also, international productions were shot here. The post-apocalyptic vibe is a dream for many filmmakers. For us, however, this wasn't fiction, but a real adventure. The Grand Powerhouse offers a brief glimpse into a forgotten era, preserved with all its glory intact. On our way to the car, we were accompanied by a feeling of elation. Not having been stopped by security, we experienced a unique sight only a small amount of people will ever be able to explore. And if you now think that this infiltration was tough, you should stay tuned. As mentioned in the beginning, there was a second power station on our bucket list. But that next exploration will be even more challenging. Yes, no kidding. Okay, here we go. We were at the outskirts of some other Hungarian town and tried to find a way on the property of the next historical power plant. It already was the second infiltration without Toby. Like before, he was sharing everything he knew, so this dangerous mission could be another success. But an uneasy feeling in our stomachs remained. It's always a leap into the unknown. We couldn't be 100% sure if Toby's info was still up to date. After all, at this point his exploration was already some months ago. But hey, adventure without risk is Disneyland, right? This is the beauty we were planning to explore. A thermal power plant which ceased operation already 20 years ago. We've been told that there were two options to get in. Number one, do we see that massive hole at ground level? We could simply walk in the boiler house, but from the guard post we could be easily spotted. The second possibility is a sneaky one. It's this large conveyor belt. We could stay away from security and climb up all the way to the roof. The downside of that, we would be partially 30 to 40 meters over ground level. Only the rotten wooden planks would be between us and the drop to death. Since the power station wasn't maintained for years, the conveyor is in a terrible condition at the moment. When we made it to the premises, we still weren't sure which one of the two options we should choose.
Und da sehen wir ja, wenn wir am Anfang des Förderbands sind, wie der Zustand ist von dem Förderband, können einschätzen, ob wir darüber.
Wenn das mit Holzbrettern ist, wäre ich da echt ungern hoch. Also es ist halt, keine Ahnung, dann lieber erwischt werden als da runterklatschen, oder?
Ja, aber es ist halt, wenn wir nicht oben langlaufen, müssen wir unten zum Kraftwerk.
Ist, ich würde auch gucken, wie viel Betrieb
erst,
ist. Erst und dann
gucken, weißt du? Erstmal spotten, ob da irgendwas ist.
Das Förderband fängt direkt hier vorne an.
Ha? Genau, das meinte er. Das Förderband ist hier vorne. Das ist halt riskant, aber blicksicher.
Ja. Soll ich mal vorgehen?
Ich würde mir erstmal das Gebäude angucken und gucken, ob wir von oben. Nee, dass wir hochkommen und aus den oberen Fenstern gucken, ob da was los ist.
So we decided to climb the small balcony here first, to get an overview of the site.
Alter, was ist das? Das ist ein sehr unangenehmes Gefühl. Alter.
This was probably the first convegia we were ever climbing up. So that feeling was totally new to us. It made us really dizzy. Getting up was feeling like we would go straight forward. But the horizon was completely twisted. We guessed it was rather not an option to climb up that huge, deadly conveyor with all the vertigo. But unfortunately, there was an unexpected problem. Workers. At this point, they were dismantling the plant and blocked the simple way in. We didn't think about that. So the single remaining option was the big feeder band. And as it looked like, it started right beneath us.
Cornelius meint hier, dieses große Förderband führt mitten in dieses Gebäude, dass wir hier in den Keller irgendwie können. Und dass das Förderband hier im Keller anfängt.
Aha.
Das heißt, wir können hier mal die Leiter nach unten gehen, gucken, ob das wirklich hier anfängt. Und dann müssen wir nämlich nicht schon mal raus.
We were lucky. The convegia was actually starting right under this building.
Da müssen wir irgendwie runter. Habt ihr den Weg? Ich guck mal hier drüben.
But everything we found was
ungarische Kunst.
After a quick look around, we found a way onto the convegia belt without exposing us too much. That's the rotten wooden floor we have been warned about. This one is supposed to carry us all the way to the top.
Was denkt ihr?
Ist das hier alles nur Holzboden?
Jo.
Und links und rechts? Auch alles nur Holz.
Ist alles Holzboden.
Ein ganz schönes Stück.
Das geht echt hoch.
Ganz schönes Stück.
Noch ein kleines Stück gehen. Wir müssen auch noch bedenken, dass sie uns vielleicht hören, ne?
Really carefully, we were moving upward. We were about to sneak inside the plant right over the heads of the workers. We really weren't sure if this was such a great idea.
Vor allem das Lustige ist, die Illusion ist, dass es ja einfach nur ein gerader Gang ist, aber wir wissen ja von außen, wie viele Meter sind das? 30?
Ja, ne? Es geht ja bis aufs Dach.
To be honest, would you do this? Sorry, Mom, if you see this.
Wir müssen die ganze Scheiße auch wieder zurück.
Vielleicht sollten wir nicht alle auf derselben Seite gehen, auf jeden Fall.
Die Stahlkonstruktion hält. Das Holz ist das einzige Kritische, glaube ich.
Also, weiter, was der Corny macht, wir folgen.
Corny, Alter, du machst gleich wieder Experimente. Ja, wir haben jetzt ein Drittel geschafft, wenn überhaupt ein Viertel, würde ich sagen.
Das macht mir den sicheren Eindruck. Warum? Ist es doppellagig? Ist es auf Stahlträgern extra gesichert?
Das sind nur Stahlträger, aber die sind halt teilweise so dünn. Das sind nur so eine Streben. Wollen wir?
Auf welchen Weg?
Genau, ich glaube, ich gehe hier weiter.
Hier weiter. Wollen wir uns vielleicht verteilen, links, rechts?
Ja. Also ich will hier laufen, dass falls ich abrutsche, dass ich mich hier noch halten kann. Oh ja, so weit, ein ganzes Viertel. Ein Viertel schon. Nie wieder. Also doch, einmal ist er wieder runter. Vor allen Dingen in dem Wissen, dass wenn wir stürzen, dann sterben wir nicht nur.
Nee, sehen uns noch.
Dann, genau, die sehen uns noch sterben. Ziemlich angebracht.
We were really glad to finally have infiltrated the power station. It was way more complicated than we thought it would be. But when we saw those 60 meter high cooling towers from the street, we knew we would try everything to explore this spectacular place. This powerhouse is only half as old as the other one we were showing to you earlier in this episode. Around 1950, the plant was built and provided especially the surrounding industry with electricity. But the 50 years it was operating, the facility was raising problems again and again. Already when the power station came on stream, there were multiple malfunctions. Reason for that were flaws with the system. And yet, this was the country's biggest investment in new industry back then. Due to the combustion of coal, power was produced here. Hence the conveyors, which transported the coal inside the boiler house. But the neighboring strip mine couldn't bring out enough coal for the huge powerhouse. So, to some extent, additional coal had to be transported here over long distances. Another problem was the major environmental pollution. Based on consequent strict environmental regulations, the plant had to be partially reconstructed and stripped down around 1990. After that, it went in private hands to be modernized later. But the development project was starting too late, because the facility wasn't needed anymore at that point. At the turn of the millennium, it was providing only a tenth of its original capacity. As a result, it was decommissioned and has been getting dismantled since then. Large parts of the massive power station haven't been existent anymore for a long time already. For example, those enormous chimneys or the turbines inside the halls of the plant. At the moment, the main part of the premises gets stripped down. So we were sharing the building with the workers, which were dismantling the place only a few floors below us. This meant we still couldn't relax.
Mehrere Arbeiter stehen da unten in der Halle. Mehrere Bahrfahrzeuge. Ich habe einen Kabelstapler gesehen, da fährt ein Bagger rum. Macht ganz schön Lärm.
Also, this power station offers impressive architecture, which we wanted to see so badly. But for that, we had to get in that hall where the construction work was going on. And it didn't look like the builders were about to leave soon. So, we weren't really sure what we should do now. That's why we were here. These are Toby's photos. Back then he didn't have to deal with those workers, so he could move freely. Pipes, stairs and ladders are creating a perfect symmetry. Together with those tall windows, impressive sceneries arise. Also here, some filmmakers were delighted in the past. This plant was used for shooting movies as well. The most prominent example is Blade Runner 2049. For the sequel of the cult film, this was the perfect post-apocalyptic set. For more of Toby's pictures, check out his Instagram. We posted the link to that in the video description. Unfortunately, those impressions were refused to us. If we had tried to capture this, we would have revealed ourselves.
Das Problem ist, wenn man das fotografieren will, muss man eben ans Geländer ran. Und dann hat man gleich gesehen.
To prevent getting caught, we decided to skip the exciting parts of the powerhouse. Instead, we wanted to find out what else there is to be discovered. Unfortunately, the demolition is already in an advanced state. But we also didn't want to be too snoopy and didn't dare to go far. We could have bumped into workers or security at any time. So, instead, it was time to end this mission. Oh yeah, totally blocked that out.
Oh, herrlich! Das sieht aus wie so ein Mistvideos. So eine Wasserrutsche.
Nur eine kaputte.
Die du auch in die Rutschen lässt.
Weil du stirbst.
Ach du Scheiße. Naja.
Weißt du, was gut gehen würde?
Was denn?
Aufs Band setzen mit dem Schlitten.
Ja, man bräuchte. Weißt du, wie es jetzt in einem Videospiel laufen würde? Du klingst so einen Haken oben rein und slidest runter.
But unfortunately, this wasn't a video game. And that thin wooden floor had to carry our weights one more time.
T-Shirt. Die haben uns gecatcht.
We had no clue where those sheep came from all at once, but apparently they were living in this room.
Das wäre doch mal ein Start für ein Videospiel. Wir haben gerade überlebt den Atom. Und alles, was überlebt hat.
Radioaktive Scheiße.
Radioaktiv. Nee.
Since the Blade Runner sequel, there's been a huge hype about this location. Urbexers from all around the world try to visit this old powerhouse. For a good reason, as you could see just now. In the past, we were exploring over a dozen forgotten industrial facilities. But the historical power plants in this episode are definitely among the best of them. After you have seen that grand architecture, hopefully you can agree when we repeat our statement from the beginning. That those once were soaring temples. We are consistently saying that we like abandoned industry the most, and because of places like these two, it will always stay that way. Here you can see some of the pictures we were taking during those two explorations. Both full albums can be found on our Google Drive, which we share with you when you support us on Patreon. The number of patrons is growing fast. Almost 100 people are supporting our project over there at the moment. Thanks a ton. Next time on Broken Window Theory. After we've done two extremely hard explorations, we were sure that everything would be possible. So we tried our luck with possibly the most unique vehicle graveyards of Hungary. On a field far away from civilization, we discovered military equipment. Around 30 jet fighters, most of them MiGs. It's really hard to exceed this find. But after that and some old hull, we're discovering numerous decommissioned trains with stunning decay. That day, rain was creating the perfect atmosphere to turn this exploration into an unforgettable memory. This was another one of our episodes. Sorry for the delay, but we hope it was worth waiting for. At this moment, we are taking part in a huge street art festival, which takes place on an abandoned property. We will release a video report about that soon. Subscribe to this channel so you don't miss it. Keep exploring and see you next time.